We're in the position of being these people that other people come up to and say, like, I would like to talk to you. I'd like to ask you a question. And then sometimes if they don't get what they want out of it, they get annoyed. And yet it's not our responsibility, ultimately, to spoon-feed the proper path of conversation or whatever.
We do it in the music. You know, we're not in the business of going around doing lectures on the songs.
Yeah, but image, too. I mean, if you wear shiny pants, right?
That's right. We're responsible for, I mean, as far as what goes on in the room of being on the stage and, to an extent, also interviews. But it's something that we don't take so seriously because we don't care about that much. You know, we mostly care about the music.
Riot trail. know, you guys become more progressively sort of like punk rock as the years go by.
Really?
And the,
that's
yeah,
a compliment.
The essence of punk rock is like not knowing.
But there was never any such
about.
Thing as punk rock.
Yeah, there was.
Not
there
knowing.
Sure,
there was an ending to punk rock, and what we're doing is we're like creating the beginning of it.
Is that just a fiction that punk rock thought it didn't know what it was talking about?
No, the best punk rock.
Punk rock was
like so self-aware that it completely transcended, like knowing what it was doing.
Okay.
There you go.
And went into something
else.
And
therefore, punk rock's what we can perceive as their origins was basically its destruction, and what we're headed to is pretty much the origin of punk rock.
Oh, it's true. I mean, it's a long cycle. I mean, it's like the hippie thing. Nobody knew about the hippie thing until it was really over.
Right.
It was born on Sharon Tate's fetus. You know what I'm saying? Sharon Tate's unborn baby was the king of the hippies.
I don't buy that.
I don't really either. But it'd make a good movie.
Yeah. You're addicted to love.